Oh, everybody. Oh, welcome to Monday, right? Welcome to Monday. Welcome to still playing Halls of Torment. Otherwise, I have no idea where my fingers. No, even with the gloves on. Cool. Oh, yeah. Right, so at the end of Saturday's session, we unlocked her. Suppose we'll give her a spin. I mean, we did so well on for Swordsman last time that now the worst hero is Archer. Actually, it's either Archer or the Huntress. I'm not really sure which. I already took the items from. Crit. Oh yeah, she can. She actually has a pretty good crit rate. Gain anything from force? Oh, more change. Wait, she actually gains block from one of her. It's also a character specific passive. There it is. So I guess he's the muscle sorceress or something. Oblivion with you. So far, I would actually say that she's probably best sort of character so far. Or, actually, Exterminators. No better. I like the Shield Maidens. Just go full block in 1-9. now. She has no base defense though. If she doesn't block, she just crumples into a pile. I'm not sure how the targeting works for the lightning. Sure as heck doesn't seem to be, like the closest target or anything like that. Yeah, I got hit once and lost like half my HP. What is her defense? Zero! Oh! Well, that explains. That explains it. So she just takes 100%. What does it say? Divided by damage rating. Yeah. So she just takes 100% damage. She doesn't dish out enough damage to get rid of all these fucking enemies. I would like to go pick up that thing, but is there even a base defense card? I'm pretty sure there isn't. All defense is percentage. So for her to get any defense at all, you'd need like an item that has flat defense on it. gonna put it on auto attacks. Think there's much he gains from manual. Choked, bitches. Guess you take aura? You can get aura to debuff. Transfix also has debuffs. Like transfix. Take auto aim off. Yeah, I'm gonna take back what I said earlier. Oh, it's actually best season. I'm gonna take back what I said earlier about her being a good character. She's good at the beginning, but her scaling is seems to be super shit. This guy's chill. Right, 2 fucking seconds. So much shit. Laying on the ground because I can't pick it up. Yeah, that zero defense is a problem. That zero defense do be a problem. But a warlock also has zero. I didn't even notice him, the warlock. Cleric is 0-1? I didn't see cleric take almost any damage. Maybe it's because he debuffs by default. Sure.
next time, bring more gold.
Oh, this gives perspective. It's interesting, this does gives block. Jeez, that's so slow. Why is force on her? H. Fire per hit, and then they're not. Ugh. Like if it was all of these others, she gets a lot of front force, but then not. The dog also had knockback. Knockback as a player thing in any game. I always hate it when like an enemy gets pushed further away from you. Actually it reduces because it changes the main weapon's damage to fire. I wonder if fire has like damaging returns on enemies or something. If it's actually better to just keep the base damage time. Right. Need to do like 0 damage for 10 minutes to get the damage 5 unlock or something. Sounds so stupid. But it's still better than using defensive abilities in the last spell to unlock better armor. God, still can't. Why? thing has much health. I actually really hate that the spear randomly splits like when you on the first throw. That an on impact. Your multi-strike makes it split more off. This map. Like the moment that second mini boss spawns. Or no wait, that's the third one. Because the first is the melee goat, then it's the archer goat. Then it's that one. Yeah, when the third mini boss spawns, like suddenly. Everything goes to shit, like nothing takes damage, etc. boys. Are they actually? Stand around for 10 minutes. Not it, so we can actually see like a timer. Hopefully. We'll do this in the base now. Not sure which level has the easiest enemies. Can you stop attacking? Doing nothing for 10 minutes. Guess I should have done this with the archer. Should have gotten the archer, don't take damage. At the same time. Maybe. Oh, actually, this map has limes. Have to be a map that doesn't spawn limes. No damage. Good. Very good, very good indeed. Follow me, boys, to the promised land. Five more minutes. I guess this also this shows that how the spawning works, so this like every wave has a max amount of units that the wave can have up at a time, and it only spawns more if you actually kill them. I guess that's how, like, the there's those kill X amount of enemies in Y amount of time and stuff. So you have to, like, basically kill enemies as they spawn or something to keep spawning more and more. so weird. This is like the thing you have to do to unlock level 5 of damage. More minutes. One minute. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Whoa, did it, boss? It's available instantly. That was most of the crits have been available instantly. No, cool. Hey. Had to send it off. I wonder, like, does this start gaining stacks even if you don't, like, haven't bought it? Like, permanent stacks, because it says that stacks don't, reset, Damage 4, so if damage 5 pops up, then that means that I'll just unlock it immediately. Probably already at minimum area. Probably no point in actually taking area minus one. So have I actually done the quest for this one? Collect the protective pendant. I wonder if it highlights it, the map. Protective pendant 0 or 2. So there is strength 5. Okay. So it does unlock it instantly. Where the fuck is this pendant there? I don't know what's the max level of ability. I just noticed there's a little marker down. Disappeared now. There's two of them. One was a potion.
Oh good.
This was not the end. I can't send anything up anymore. What's the point? I suppose I've walked like the complete wrong way. light. It's interesting that so far there hasn't been a lifesteal, like, item or stand. I'm pretty sure I actually said that the first time we played the early access version. Okay, what? Just got an achievement or an unlock slash achievement for never picking a health upgrade. But I mean, the health upgrade barely does anything. More of a like emergency heal. Kind of thing, like if you're almost out of health, and if you take the base health, you gain just a little bit. The health as a stat is kind of pointless compared to just flat defense and block, right? It's not like you can gain that, like the available regen, and yeah, like I just said, the no health, no vampiric aura or anything. What's the point of having more max health if there's barely any way to get it back even? And the name of the game is like avoiding getting hit anyway. Or just ignoring getting hit once you have defense and block. For a moment I completely forgot his face too. That almost sounds like music, but going on. So we'll do one more run. See about doing something else for a bit. Do we go for a pendant or? For this song. Not take the burning damage this time. You want her. Her regular damages. Take that for the moment. I guess this also applies on Frost and Spark. auto forley first. Where is she aiming? Does she have a minimum range of fucking hell? Don't say anything about a minimum range. But it does seem like she has one. Destroy area. Maybe it's the auto. Is that my fire range? Okay, she definitely has a minimum range. Just not shown anywhere. God, it's so hard to tell. Okay, it's not minimum range, it's just like the forks prefer targets that are further or something. Targeting for the vultures. Doesn't like even seem to be seeking targets all the time. Right there, I was like at the perfect range from sky. And all half of the bolts just kept going around him. They crash now because oh, gives you like a small grace period. It's so annoying that you have to stop. Wasn't there something similar? The Vampire Survivors. There was like one of the character weapons. A thing you had to stop every now and then. The drill thing you get for the girl with the guitar for unlocking her. Like it spawned them pointing in the direction you were moving, but then you had to stop to actually launch them. Yeah. Even with the defense item, it's it takes so much fucking damage. Doesn't she like if I have when I have the items? She should have like 20 starting. Is as much as Norseman. I don't understand why she takes so much. It's 10 from... probably 20 with these. Also this mark thing. I've unlocked a single one. Every character has their own mark. One more character at least there. 5 for 12. Have I not survived even 12 minutes in the in this map? What the Any? Give it one more go. Just in the until the 12 minute mark. get it. I marked it, right? It doesn't say on this screen. I have only one banish. It keeps trying to give me the creep. So, where's chat Torino? Like, I think Twitch chat is exploding. Keeps reconnecting. Wave. Oh, I guess this. Ghouls are so spread out. Okay, it's actually something on this level itself, it seems. Even this guy is taking so much damage from it. So the enemies on this level, I guess, ignore defense. Some part of defense. Wait, when? I just noticed the objective says survive for 18 minutes, but the quest said 12, right? Am I being scammed? Yeah. Oh, until there are 12. God damn it. I have been truly debated. Can y'all like take damage or something? These cubes are even more annoying than the slimes. They're like this level's version of the slimes, but even more annoying than the slimes are. Are like completely malfunction. Sorry, getting super cold in Finland. Just suddenly, it was like yesterday it started getting cold, and then today was, or rather, I guess last Friday it was starting to get cold already. And it's just just live in a country that has 20 degrees all year round. Apparently there's like, I actually looked it up at some point. Just curious if there's like a always medium temperature. There are places where it's always cold, where it's always warm and stuff. But I was wondering, like, is there a place that's always a nice temperature? And apparently there is. Apparently Ecuador is basically 20 all year round. But apparently Ecuador is also the crime capital of the world. Why can't we have nice things? Charges when dealing damage. Our damage is based on your max level. Every time you do a portion of your max health in damage, you get 10 max health and 0.1 damage. I think I had so much less health than me. What color? Where'd all the enemies go? This wave has like so few enemies. Suddenly everything just walks straight into. Going on? Can I also turn off auto? Jesus. What are these random ass eruptions? Gotta be an upgrade for a hailstorm to automatically fire. Right. But to unlock any upgrades for it, it needs to actually do damage first. Been the thing for most of the abilities. That run straight at you. And shoot. And more cubes got. Stop it, the cubes. Oh god.
Did somebody ask for more cubes? Sure, we have more cubes.
Not a good idea to put my back in the wall. So aggressive. Help me. Hey, we did it. New character. Well, might as well keep going. See if we can't get this done. If I had only read that, I mean, correctly the first time. Defeat the village, huh? The alternative to that ability that I was hovering over. Seems a little weird. Was, shows the more spread as like a negative, but for the flamethrower, seems like it should be a positive. Oh, there's a elite. Seven notes. Huh? Oh, because like, shouldn't you have offered the upgrade for the hail? I guess the plane took its place. Oh, the fucking balls are pushing the... It's like, how are the enemies jumping at me? But it's the... It's those fucking balls are pushing the other enemies for... God. So much hell. Everything in this level has so much. God, and there's special cubes.
want you to die.
See something. You really need. God. Oh God. What the.
These fucking cubes, fuck.
The ball. I have to keep moving to avoid this fucking cube so I can't see where the ball. Ow. And now there's more meatballs pushing these. God damn. Jesus, this level. Why? Such a Shield Maiden level, I guess. It's like once you stack up enough defenses on her, and she just doesn't take any damage at all. Holy heck. I would like if I could actually kill the fucking one. I can't even see. Keep running from this goddamn meat. Is there a second? Can we stop with the cubes already? Splash damage enemy spawns again. Hellstorm actually does so much damage if it actually lands on enemies. Oh! Oh! Where's the boss? Takes literally no damage. I suppose I can't. I'm not even reaching him because I have zero range. Turn on auto aim and try to aim the hailstorms. Focus on moving. Oi! What the fuck? That's something. Also, the AoE for the hailstorm, the crashing was like much, much larger than the actual graphic for it. I guess it doesn't like properly like it's maybe it's like it just dissipates very very fast for the graphic. Oof, oof. Landsknecht. Gunman or something? Oh, is it? It's a it's this thing opened. Oh, this is agony mode. Oh, okay. So I guess that was the final level then. There's like the agony mode versions. I guess these mats have to be somewhere in Agony. Oh, there's five. I guess they're like one in each of the Agony modes.
Take good care of yourself. Step closer. Be something. My guest. Well, well. Goodbye.
Money. Huh. See. Have we defeated the boss in every level? Then that's technically, I guess, game complete if we have. I'm here, I'm pretty sure. Completed this one. I haven't completed quests for any of the maps, I think. Oh, I guess we haven't killed the boss of Frozen. Technically one boss left.
If you count it like that.